not a witch! I know her!
Out of the way! You expect preferential treatment just because you are her brother? She will burn. All witches must burn.
Berthold, don't let them take me! I swear I've done nothing wrong!
Silence your lying tongue, foul!
Guards, to me!
You appeared as if from nowhere. We would both be dead if not for you.
We are forever in your debt. I cannot thank you enough.
I must get my sister to safety. But first, I may know of a way to thank you. There's a safe in the bunkhouse. The combination is 203. Take what you want, and good luck.
probably rat into everything.
Guard! Shout if you see him.
Though, it's just a little cough. I'm fine. I feel completely fine.
Fine? Look at you. You... What the plague? You are trying to conceal it from us.
Your brother's in the Order.
Was that your to spread the malady to us?
No, friend. I tell you, I am world. As fit as ever. Put down your weapons. Just think for a moment before you.
He was sick. Very, very sick. That much I'm sure of.
Now to find some way to dispose of the body without spreading his illness.
Should we gather for whiskey and cigars tonight?
Indeed. I believe so.
This would have gotten so bad if that damn fool Corvo hadn't killed the Empress.
Is that you?
Hey, Corvo. It's Samuel. From the way I hear it, Campbell lived a pretty posh life. Maybe it's not my place to say. Men of the faith shouldn't live like barons. Are you ready to go? Okay, let's go.
Admiral Havelock and Lord Pendleton are in the courtyard. I expect they'll want to congratulate you.
My uncle's been killed, hasn't he? I know he never came back from the meeting with High Overseer Campbell. I don't know why I expected anything else.
They're all corrupt. If this is going to work, we have to take down the Lord Regent and all of his key allies. You know that.
Yes. Hopefully the High Overseer is the first step along that path.
And we must You did it! Somehow you took down the High Overseer Campbell against the odds. I knew you were our man, Corvo. With Campbell gone, we've hurt the Lord Regent immeasurably. And with Martin back, we'll have the finest strategist alive.
The Lord Regent must be shitting himself in Dunwall Tower.
Yes, and Campbell's journal, let's not forget. Our hope is that in these encoded pages, the location and condition of Emily Caldwin can be discovered. Our entire movement will mean nothing if we can't place the rightful heir on the throne. We must act fast. No doubt the Lord Regent is holding Emily somewhere, waiting to reveal her, to step out as the hero and further cement his regency.
If he doesn't bring the young lady forth soon, there will be infighting among the nobles as to who should succeed the Empress.
Yes, time is against us. But now you should take a well-earned rest, Corvo. We will decipher the contents of the High Overseer's journal and share them with you later.
Thank you. Remember Miriam's wedding, Uncle? Even the cousins were there, in from the farms. Yours was the only house big enough for all of us. The baker used two carts to bring in all the bread and sweets. Two carts, full to the brim. I blamed Bradley for stealing the icing balloons on top of the cake, but you were right, of course it was me. How did you know? But didn't we look fine? So many of us then. And remember when the streamers caught fire? They burned so fast. We all ran screaming, but not you, Uncle. Remember? You found each little fire and put them out one by one. I thought you were the bravest man alive. We all did. Uncle Curnow.
I know the Golden Cat, not as a patron, mind you. I designed some specialized devices for them. I kept the blueprints, if anyone is curious.
Don't. I brought you tea as a courtesy to a colleague. I won't make that mistake in the future.
I'm sorry, I only thought... Never mind what I thought. Thank you for the tea.
I have to get back to the Admiral. He has news for me.
Corvo, my friend, do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
Hello, Corvo. I expect Martin will be joining us shortly. I hate to start your day with such a strange matter, but the servants heard something last night, moving through the storm drains beneath the building. Most likely a weeper, the poor bastard. There's no hope for them once the plague gets that far along. Nothing more than a shuffling corpse full of sickness and insects, if you ask me. I'd appreciate you investigating, just to be sure it's not a nosy guardsman that's getting too close. Here's a key to the hatches. I'd send a servant down there, but they'd die of fear on the spot, I'm afraid. Maybe Piero can concoct some sort of sleep poison for your crossbow if you want to go that route.
It is every citizen's duty to report treason of speech and action. The state depends on you.
You went down there in the sewers? I thought I heard a weeper in there earlier. You're probably the bravest man I've ever met. Overseer Martin has arrived. He's with Admiral Havelock now. They want to talk to you.
You're lucky I keep you on.
Lucky? This place would fall apart in 10 minutes without me.
Is that so?
In any case, you can't dismiss me. I went through the books this morning and found 5 mistakes you've made.
Very well.
You're lucky I found them before the Admiral did.
My master had a very fitful night. No one sleeps well here.
Corvo, I trust you remember Martin, an overseer before, and perhaps again someday soon.
I owe you thanks for my rescue.
Indeed. You've given us a glimmer of hope, Corvo. Because we've gotten what we wanted from Campbell's journal. You've done it. We know where Emily Caldwin is being held.
The Golden Cat, of all places. A bathhouse for aristocrats. Little better than a cursed brothel.
But there's an unfortunate twist. It appears that Pendleton's own kinsmen stand in our way. The twins, Morgan and Custis. Not only are they controlling Emily, but they have the controlling parliamentary votes we so desperately need.
Yes, the Pendletons have to die. But most importantly, Emily must be brought here safely so we can protect her until the Lord Regent and his entourage have been dealt with. Pendleton's waiting for you on the dock. He's asked to brief you personally. I think it's best.
Corvo, a moment if I may. Corvo, I've asked to speak to you myself. You see, I'm sending you to kill my older brothers, Morgan and Custis. They're horrible men. It's true, as you may have heard, cruel beyond words. Further, my brothers are close allies to the Lord Regent, and as long as they are in Parliament, we cannot gather the votes we'll need to stop the Lord Regent from further consolidating his power. These days, they're best known for exploiting their favor with him to cheat others out of their wealth. Let's just say that not every family evicted in quarantine for having the plague actually has the plague. I warned my brothers in every way I could. I really did. But they never did listen to me. They'll be at the Golden Cat tonight at their usual revels. They'll be protected by the city watch, so it'll be dangerous. Now go. Please do it before I change my mind.
Corvo, my friend. Do you need ammunition or weaponry? Would you like me to craft something for you?
Take you to the Golden Cat when you're ready. I've taken Lord Pendleton enough times, believe me.
You as close as I can to the Golden Cat, Corvo. You'll have to go the rest of the way on your own. The entrance is near Holger Square. The main thing is to make sure that little girl, Emily, gets back all safe and sure. Them two Pendletons are there, so I'm guessing there'll be a lot of guards. Slackjaw might have some ideas on helping you get inside the cat if he don't kill you. This here's his territory.
He and his Bottle Street gang hole up at the old Dunwall Whiskey Factory. They sell the elixir that folks use to fight off the plague. I'll lay low, but keep an eye out for you and the little lady you're bringing back. Good luck to you. I know Emily must mean a lot to you. Be careful going up the street, Corvo. A river hand I know pulled up alongside me last night and said there's one of those watchtowers on Cloud right now.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Anyone with information pertaining to the death of High Overseer Thaddeus Campbell is to report to the City Watch for immediate questioning. In this time of spiritual trouble, the Overseer has initiated...
that him?
Yeah, he's the one.
Hey, we got a message for you from Slackjaw. He wants to talk at the distillery. Slackjaw be waiting for you. Easy, easy. You just need a bit. Ain't you heard? Slackjaw keeps the good stuff. So, rest of us get one part elixir, three parts water down.
Oh, that's just to make the swallowing go smooth.
Well, I ain't taking no chances on getting the blade. Drink till you drop, that's my motto.
My men were right. You do look like a man out for murder. Way I figure it, there ain't nobody worth killing around here except those two Pendletons over at the Golden Cat. I'm right, ain't I? See, Slackjaw knows. Them boys are twins. Rich, mean, and weird. Worse than most of their ilk. They've been laying low there a while, not sure why. There's a lot of security at the Golden Cat tonight, though. Special guests and the like. But you're gonna walk in there, dressed like that, and kill the Pendleton brothers? Maybe I got a better way to take care of them, too. If you're doing something for me first, understand? Someone, I don't know who, is killing my men, taking my territory, stealing my goods. Might be a fellow named of Galvani. I sent my best man to investigate, but he went missing and... Well, now I need someone to find what happened to him. Go to this Galvani's place. He lives nearby off Clavering Boulevard. You do that for me and I'll get you a better way into the Golden Cat.
Up anything good?
Blow off, Joffer.
Mm-hmm.
up later and take a look, after them other two are gone. Huh?
Should we gather for whiskey and cigars tonight?
Indeed, I believe so.
yourself.
Can't stay hidden forever.
Eyes sharp. Call out to each other if you spot him.
Hey, wait a bit. What just occurred to me? How come it's always me who pay for the whiskeys?
Shush up your mouth. You know I can't work out the right number of coin. Embarrassing.
What's this?
Information from my missing guy. Let's have a listen.
Blackjaw, it's me, Crowley. I'm making this in case I don't make it back. He was right. There is someone wants you dead. Wants to take over the distillery and the whole Bottle Street gang. And you'll never believe who it is, neither. At first I didn't. That's why it's taken me so long. Wanted to be sure. And what's that? Fire! No! No! Ah!
So Crowley's dead. Too bad. He was one of my best men. Still, you and me had a deal, and Slackjaw never goes back on a deal. Take this key. It ain't for the Golden Cat, no. This key's for the captain's chair. A hotel abandoned since the plague gutted this part of town. Take the stairs to the top. You can use the roof to get into the Golden Cat brothel. See that? Slackjaw keeps a bargain. Just as good as them men who run the city. Maybe a little better. You think about that. Now maybe we can help each other out again. I could get rid of the Pendletons for you, quiet-like and without killing them. But you gotta do something for me in return. The Cat's having a big reopening tonight. Lot of money clients, including an arts dealer named Bunting. He's got particular tastes, or so I've been told by some of the ladies. Got some pretty fancy stuff locked away at his place, and the only thing preventing me from nabbing all that loot is the combination to his safe. Of course, the Pendletons have been camped out there for months too, not sure why. So that means a lot of the City Watch and other soldier types. Bring me that combination, my masked friend, and then I take care of the Pendleton brothers, just like that. You ain't never even gonna touch them. And I promise, I won't kill him, and no one will ever see them again. Now, if that ain't a deal, Slackjaw don't know what is.
Attention Dunwall citizens, a mandatory whale oil ration is now in effect. Non-compliance is a punishable offense. Attention, Dunwall citizens. This district is now under a mandatory whale oil ban. Compliance will be strictly enforced. Thank you.
show yourself. I will find you soon enough. I demand that you show yourself. I will find you soon enough.
I know you're here. Where are you?
Now Morgan's on the first. Need to get the men in position.
I demand that you show you.
The ivory room. All I can tell you is it's very heavily soundproofed. I'll leave the rest to your imagination. Custis is easier to manage. Some nights he just waits in the smoking room upstairs and talks. It's funny what people will pay for.
She really likes me.
Idiot. She likes your money, not you.
You're just jealous.
Shut up.
Huh? What the fuck?
What is it?
Someone help me out!
Just get around him!
I'll fuck
hit him!
Yeah. Huh. Stay hidden forever.
The Pendletons are here. You're supposed to be on duty.
Come on.
You're supposed to be on guard. You'll get dismissed for sure. I can't believe this. You said you weren't even drunk. Wake up.
Who do you want me to be tonight, Lord Pendleton?
Anyone you want. The High Overseer, for all I care. I've never been this drunk.
Some of my friends say I look like Lady Boyle.
Waverly? That lucky trollop. If I'd found those crystal deposits on my estate, I'd be throwing parties too. I'd be buying the Lord Regent's favor too, instead of begging for money.
I didn't mean to upset you, my lord.
Heaven's dice.
On second thought, maybe you should just...
I would be glad to, my lord. Would you like me in white or black? Or red, perhaps?
Let me think about this. Waverly did always like black. Or was that Lydia?
Just see what happens if I get another crack at this guy.
Probably just a draft.
When I find you, it's going to be bad.
Where are you? Oh, I'll find you.
None of this would have
Lord
gone
Pendleton
so
has been killed. I know you're here.
Keep skulking around. I gotta stop showing
hands. I know you're here.
Nothing here.
Huh.
write to her again. She has to see reason.
Stay hidden for long. You got lucky this time.
Count dice.
I know you're somewhere around here.
Can't stay hidden forever.
Thank you.
I find you, it's going to be bad. Where are you?
That's beautiful, honey.
Go on with what you were saying, Morgan.
And so then, the vote is 43-41 against us. But the bylaws stay.
The Lord Regent's provisional bylaws?
That's exactly right. They state that the conservative position gets an extra 3 votes.
But not in the month of Timber.
Is that true? How on earth do you know that?
Did you think I was born a courtesan, Lord Pendleton? I was a clerk to Lord Estermont before.
Whatever happened to old Estermont?
The rats did. An old sewer line led under his office in Parliament in one time. Help! Someone help me!
are you? Why are you wearing that mask? Corvo? Corvo, it's you! You're wearing a mask to sneak around, aren't you? They told me you were head chopped off and in the prison, dead, like Mother. That seems like a long time ago. But you're not dead. Now we can leave. I have a plan. I almost got away twice. There's a special door to come and go for special people, and I'll show you. And if anyone tries to stop us, you can fight them. It's this way. Door is locked. Unlock it so we can get away from this place. This place is on the river, so you must have come by boat. I'll wait for you near the boat. I remember the way. Don't worry about me.
Come to dinner now, that's right, my sweet little birds. Come to Granny. Granny won't hurt you. My, my. First you're here, then you're there. Now you're dragging a sweet girl across town with you. Tell him, won't you, if you see him?
All right, Dunwall citizen.
She has
anyone with
reason.
Information pertaining to the death of Ivan.
I hear you, Master.
cut. Velvet Sono. Harlan Gun. That's it.
Ready to go? Corvo, you must have worked wonders out there in the city tonight. I can't believe my old eyes. So you did the business, did you, Corvo? I'm not one to speak against my betters, mind you, but if anybody ever deserved their fate, it was those Pendletons.
What business are you talking about?
Oh, grown-up business, girl. I mean, your ladyship. Forgive me.
It's okay. I heard a lot of grown-up business at the Golden Cat.
Oh. I should concentrate on piloting this boat.
Young Lady Emily, I'm Callista. I'll be caring for you and schooling you while you're with us.
Pleased to meet you.
As am I. Would you like to see your room in the tower?
Can I see it?
Yes, you may. You'll get to see it all. The entirety of the Hound Pits.
Good. I think I'll like it here. I'll go with Callista, Corvo. I'll see you later.
You do not fail to impress. Armed with a blade, you've changed the course of the city forever. And with the Pendleton twins gone, our own Lord Pendleton will assume their votes in Parliament. In one night, you've done more than most men do in a lifetime. I need to speak to you soon. But for now, Lord Pendleton requests your attention. Thank you.